Hello friends, in last lecture we have seen the complete design procedure for hydrodynamic journal pairing. After design procedure, and you have already you also know in design procedure there is a temperature change delta T, okay. So let us discuss about the temperature rise in hydrodynamic journal pairing with feed lubrication. So here you can see the total flow of lubrication oil is Q, okay. So the analysis of temperature rise is assumed that the total flow Q of the lubricating oil is responsible for the total heat dissipation. Means, so Q is responsible for heat dissipation. Heat flow as increased, heat dissipation is also increased. Now circumference, there are two types of Q here, that is the circumferential flow due to relative motion and axial flow, or we can say side leakage, right? So you know the circumferential flow due to the relative motion QC. So because temperature rise in the circumferential flow is T1 minus T2 is equal to delta T. And axial flow, that means the side leakage, you can understand this side leakage, or we can say axial flow. So average temperature, it is assumed that the axial flow take place at the average temperature, that is T1 plus T2 by 2, okay. So here we can say T average minus T1 is equal to T1 plus T2 by 2 for the temperature rise in the axial flow is given by, right. So here T average minus T1, so here this is T average minus T1, so finally T2 minus T1 by 2. So here T2 minus T1, that is delta T by 2. So we have one equation right now, T average minus T1 is equal to delta T by 2. Now two things we have to compare, that is the heat generation and heat dissipation. So whatever the heat generated, it must be dissipate, okay. Then and then we can say temperature will be the balance, right. So here the power lost in the friction is given by, so here we can say, sorry, the power loss is same as the temperature generation, right. So friction torque FWR upon 10 raised to 3 into angular velocity, that is 2 pi ns, okay. So W is equal to FWR into 2 pi ns upon 10 raised to 3 in upon 10 raised to 3 kilowatt. So here we convert it into the kilowatt, watt to kilowatt, okay. This is actually watt, okay. Now we have this equation, frictional torque, frictional power, or we can say power loss in friction. So here all these terms you know very well, ns, that is the journal speed, f, that is the coefficient of friction, w, that is the radial load, r, that is the journal radius. So heat generation is basically 2 pi ns fwr upon 10 raised to 6 kilojoule per second, right. So here kilowatt converted into the kilojoule per second. So this is about the heat generation, right. Now let us see the rate of heat dissipation. So HD is equal to, here all the nomenclatures, you can pause the video and see all the nomenclatures, okay. So M is equal to rho Q upon 10 raised to 9 kg per second. So here heat dissipate is equal to MCP delta T. This is a basic equation which we have studied in engineering thermodynamics, okay. MCP delta T plus MSCP delta T by 2, that is the heat carried by the axial flow, and this is heat carried by the circumferential flow, right. So when we having add this value at the end, we got rho Cp delta T upon 10 raised to 9 bracket Q minus Qs plus Qs by 2. So this is the equation for heat dissipation, right. Now we have two equation, one is heat generation, okay, 2 pi ns FWR upon 10 raised to 6, and heat dissipation, that is rho Q Cp delta T bracket 1 minus 1 upon 2 Qs minus Qs upon Q bracket over. So this both equation maybe you find in design data book, okay. You just see the design data book, maybe this equation will be there. So the temperature rise delta T is equal to heat generation is equal to heat dissipation. So here, if we compare this, then we can get the answer in form of delta t. This is the delta t. Okay, all other values we know, right? So ns, all the things given here. So this is the delta t that we have to find. That is called the change in temperature, right? Now, viscosity of lubricating oil mu. So here the effective temperature of the lubricating oil is given by effective temperature T is equal to T1 plus 0.8 delta T. Okay, so T1 is the inlet temperature, T2 is the outlet temperature of lubricating oil, and delta T is equal to T2 minus T1. So when we put this value in T average, we can find out, okay, T average, the average temperature of lubricating oil is T1 plus T2 by 2 minus T1. So here, this equation is modified by 2T1 minus T1, that is called the T1. So 2T1 plus T2 minus T1 by 2. So we can say T1 plus T2 minus T1 up by 2. So here this is the delta T. So finally we can say T average is equal to T1 plus delta T by 2. Okay. So this is nothing but the 2T1 minus T1, that is T1, right? So by this way we get this equation. So today this is enough. Next time we will see the examples. So thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.